Ewidence-based active learning is known to engage students with concepts and to generate feedback during peer interactions. Using the same activity to start a new module and again to resolve the lesson also prepares students for learning, then drives home key concepts and demonstrates learning gains.
In today's class, students basically were answering similar questions at the beginning and at the end of the worksheets. I did this for a couple reasons. One, in the beginning, I wanted to ask questions to get a sense of what they already knew coming in, so I could get an idea of how much the students knew about the topic of the day. I then repeated it at the end to show them that they had a lot more information. So we're going to start off with a worksheet here. So Drew and I are going to pass this out. And you can just fill out your name and whatnot on this right now. And the very first question, I'm going to show you a video and ask you some questions about what you see in the video.
How did students react to using worksheets in this first year science course about natural disasters?
I make sure that the activities are being used on the first day. So I start using worksheets and activities right away. I find that students very quickly get an expectation of what the course is like, and they will react strongly if you try to change things too much.
Okay, so this is one after we're done this. Hopefully I'll remember. I'd like you to hand this one back in because I want to have an idea of what you think. So we're going to start with this video I mentioned.
Students watch the short video, then answer an open-ended question alone before addressing further short answer questions in groups.
Okay, take a minute. Write down what you saw. Things you think were important. And then once you've finished doing that, start going through the rest of the worksheet, and you can do that with your neighbors.
By doing it in a group, you get to have other ideas, and sometimes you're right, sometimes you're wrong. And it's all feedback to help you learn.
One of the benefits I see of using worksheets and lots of activities for the students, in the end, they're the ones who have to show that they know how to do the skill. It's nice to actually have them practice it. Sometimes they'll come to me expressing frustration that they don't know things. And this is actually good because it means the students are starting to take control of their learning and they're aware when they don't know something, instead of what often happens, which is they think everything's fine until they have to repeat the skill on an exam.
A teaching assistant in large classes will help keep tutoring ratios close to one guide for roughly 50 students. Helping in class is also an important experience for graduate students.
You take a cookie sheet and you put an ice cube on it, you bend the cookie sheet, the ice cube's going to slide down. That would be an example of translation, right?
Can we collect worksheet one first? Everybody in this section, pass it to this aisle. Everybody in this section, pass it over here and I'll come pick it up.
Students took roughly 10 minutes to complete this activity. Results are not discussed yet because the same activity will be reused at the end of the lesson. Lecturing, including clicker questions and other active strategies, begins now with students having been primed to learn new material.
Made of broken pieces glued together, and this is just a bunch of sediment.
With 10 to 15 minutes left in the lesson, students are asked to redo this activity.
Okay, anyone having deja vu? Yeah, you got 2.5 hours of landslide knowledge into you. Let's see how you do. Let's show this video again. Here's your retaining wall. Any questions here? No? Okay.
Is it just kind of like based on what we covered today?
Well, has it changed? Has what you've thought about, what you think about landslides, has it changed? Would you write something different now than you wrote before?
I have no idea.
You don't have any idea?
No, I don't.
Well, so I actually did run into one student who, at the end of the class, was saying, well, I don't know anything. Can you guess? Well, so what are your three options?
Landslide.
And I said, well, what can you tell from these details? And she sort of looked at me and went, oh, I know that. And does that look like it's all still in one chunk? Or does it look like the trees have been mashed a little bit? That's kind of nice. So in the two ways, I'm focusing on the information, I'm prepping them, I'm learning what they know. Then at the end, I'm summarizing and seeing what they picked up, but also I'm showing them that there's a change. They're able to look at themselves and say, oh, I didn't know this 2 hours ago, and now I do know it. So I find that quite helpful and useful for their state of mind as well. Okay, cool. Okay, so let's go through this a little bit. The first question is about the video, right? What other things do you notice about the video that you didn't see before?
It might have been like a complex movement.
tasks and questions are resolved using a Socratic whole class discussion after students have completed the activity a second time. They are allowed to keep results for studying purposes.
Translational, okay, why? Because
it
stays together, so that's why it's a slide, and then?
One lateral movement in a straight
line. I think that the kind of characteristics you need to be able to teach this way, it's easier if you're willing to sort of be out there and let the students have control for a little while. But I think that anyone can teach this way. At this moment, what is that car?
Debris.
Debris. And what is this material doing? Flowing. Think about that on your drive home. Thank you all for participating today.